Everybody, welcome back to With Popcorn. Thank you for clicking on this video. Today we're going to be talking about Fractured. Fractured is a Netflix original. It is a thriller. It is 1 hour and 40 minutes long. Wait, did I just say thriller? I saw a thriller, you guys. What? There's nothing scary about it. I guess it is thrilling. Yes. Okay, that is correct. Sometimes I mix them both up. Yeah, I know how I am with my horror. The initial release was September 22nd and is directed by Brad Anderson. So before I officially go on with the review, I just want to say that from this review forward, I will no longer be telling you verbally who's starring in whatever it is that I'm watching. From now on, I'm just going to be showing you photos of who stars in it. The reason for that, if you guys are new and the people who've been with me for a while know, and you're probably like, finally, I don't know how to correctly pronunciate people's names. I could barely even say that damn word. I don't think there's been a single review where I have said the whole cast name correctly. I'm always butchering somebody's name. I hope you guys enjoy my new style. Now, this story follows Ray, Joanna, and the daughter Perry. So when Perry is in an accident and she falls over this like little dam deal, the dad is trying to, you know, get her but doesn't quite catch her in time, and they both fall. After the fall, Joanna obviously goes to Perry first, just trying to wake her up, and then goes over there to Ray to kind of get him to react. Once he kind of, you know, comes out of the shock of what's happening, they kind of head off to the hospital, and that's kind of where this whole movie kind of takes place, is in the ER. They finally get checked in. The intake lady is pretty much asking them these like random questions, and it's really trying to force the whole organ donor deal to them. And so that right there already starts going like, ooh, well, that's what's happening here, right? They're trying to harvest these people's organs. You see a lot of like really suspect things going on there. So after the doctor examines Perry, they decide to do like an MRI, I believe it was, or was it a CT? I think it was an MRI, just to make sure there was nothing wrong internally. They do only allow one parent to accompany the minor to the imaging facility. And of course, mom is the one that goes. Dad then goes off and waits in the waiting room. He ends up falling asleep. And now we kind of go into the next day, and where's Perry and Joanna? Nobody knows. I really want to make this into a spoiler, you guys, because it's been out for a minute. It really has. I'm going to make it into a spoiler. We're going to do a spoiler, you guys. Actually, you know what? We're going to do a Fractured recap. I have never recapped a movie before, and I feel like that's where I'm going to go with this. Which, mind you, we had just seen the family interact with the doctor, right? But of course the doctor's all like, no, like, we never saw your family. We saw you, we treated you for a head wound. Everybody's being really kind of like vague. The way that they make you feel is that the whole hospital is in on this whole deal. Like, they are kidnapping these people, they're harvesting their organs, they're doing stuff, and everybody's in on it. Like, you better be, watch out. So he got out from the room that the rent-a-cop pretty much put him in after he mazed them. So he did find some adrenaline. It's not coming out, you guys. Yeah, know what I'm talking about. And he injects it. He injects like 3 pins. He escapes. And when he gets outside, he runs into this cop car, and he's pleading his case to the two cops. So when they're going out there investigating all that's going on, of course, hospital is telling them their side of the story, which is what he already told Ray. And so the cops are just kind of like, well, who do we believe in a way? So they try to take him upstairs, and he's all like, no, 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 no. I saw this. Y'all went downstairs, and they're just like, no. Downstairs, there's no imaging. The imaging is upstairs. And so they end up going upstairs. Why the cops didn't insist on possibly going downstairs and then upstairs? Kind of go with maybe something horrific happened, and your mind unknowingly just kind of blocked that out and put it something else. She then says, let's go over there to the place where you said that your daughter fell. Maybe they're still there. You know, maybe you think that you came over here with them, but they're probably still there. You know, maybe they're hurt, you know. So it kind of starts going with, well, maybe he killed them, you know, or did they ever really exist? I'm finding this big old puddle of blood, and he's all like, no, that's my blood. Like, I fell, like I had a head wound. No, this is like a lot of blood. That this is not from that. At this point, you guys, is when I asked Desiree, do you think it's real? Do you think the family is dead? Did the family truly ever exist? And Desiree said, no, I think it's real. I think the hospital has, you know, the family. And I'm like, I know, right? That could be it. And then I was like, well, what if the twist to the twist is that, you know, what really happened? I actually, at this point, you guys, I actually figured it out. I was so smart. So let's kind of like keep moving ahead. You know, he's going downstairs to the imaging where he saw his family be taken to. In the midst of that, the security guard ends up getting to the elevator as well. And he kills the security guard. He goes into this room where he sees these two boys cut open with all their organs removed. There he ends up seeing the lady that did the intake. So he follows her. Lo and behold, he finds Perry laying down on the surgery table. He looks over to the side. That's where he sees Joanne. And he takes them. When they're in the car, you know, of course, Joanna's all like, you saved us. And then, you know, he's just like happy as dandy can be because he saved his family. He looks, you know, in the mirror to see his family. He sees his family, but there's nobody back there. Or they didn't exist, right? But no, that was the twist. Right. We replay quickly what kind of happened from the fall. So in that fall, Perry didn't make it. And Joanna's just like hitting him, and he just kind of like pushes her off to the side, which you see happen in the first go around, but it was a construction site, so there was nails just kind of sticking over. So she fell into a nail and died, which then makes sense because throughout the movie she does complain about having a headache. Still in a very state of shock, he picks up his family and puts them into the backseat of his car. He does drive to the hospital, he does check himself in, and he does get stitched up. So in fact, everything that the doctor said was in fact true. He was the patient, he's the one that they saw, not the family. So the daughter was an accident, you know, it was, the dog was real. Now the wife, on the other hand, you know, he just kind of just chunked her to the side, so yeah, you would have got charged for that one. So where his mind was, you know, playing tricks on him and made him see things, he actually kidnapped somebody who was on the surgery table. So obviously who was in the back seat was about to die too. So then now Fractured does have a lot of mixed reviews. I personally enjoyed it. I really did. It grabbed me. I wasn't scared with it. I don't know how I feel about that. And it kept me entertained. Do I recommend for you to see Fractured? Yes, I do. And it's just on Netflix, you guys. So just like, you know, it's winter. So it's perfect time to just kind of like cozy up and just like get your hot cocoa, get your cafecito. You want to be a little extra, you know, add a little Baileys. If you guys have seen Fracture on Netflix, let me know down below what you guys thought about it. But before you guys click out of this video, don't forget to give it a like. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't yet. Don't forget to hit that notification bell so you'll be notified when I post something new. And until next time, I'll be seeing you guys at concessions. Bye!